There are trillions of stars in the cosmos. Each of those stars are their own little universe that is identical, yet very different. One realm may even be exactly as yours, except a family of bears were murdered. This may end up not causing the realm to look any different than yours outside of a few unexpected events. On the other hand, with such a massive shatter event, this could completely change the landscape of the realm. It is these details that causes an infinite number of realms to grow, like hairs in a coat of fur. Every hair grows the same, but when examined closer, some hairs look radically different. Some are matted as they've absorbed despair and turmoil. Others may have grown thin from lack of nutrition. More still, there are some hairs that have just lost their luster and shine. I have come to call some of these hairs anomalies, because no matter what realm they exist, they find a way. Do not be mistaken, this doesn't mean they find the same path, no matter what realm it is, but more that their fundamental core remains intact even if their shell may have been altered from the bombardment of shatters. One such anomaly is a bear by the kind name of Seni Ursa. In your universe, they are a bear that lost their bear family and then were found by a clan of kitties. In another universe, however, the bear family was murdered, and they became a world-class detective, but still could not solve the murder case. Naturally, this is what fuels their obsession to solve crimes, wanting to bring every criminal to justice. And this is where our tale shall begin. I find myself in a noisy city, brimming with life and shining brightly with various neon signs. I'm unsure where the city is, but I can tell the air is a little tense. I felt a little similar tension before. Something dark is going on here. That's when I hear a voice.
Excuse me, sir. You're currently in the middle of our crime scene. Would you mind stepping back?
I raise a brow as I look around me. It looks like I was sitting in the middle of where a burglary occurred. I quickly get up and brush myself off. My apologies. I didn't mean to tamper with any evidence. Are you the detective in this case? The elderly gentleman gave a hearty laugh.
No, I'm just an old cat clawing his way to retirement. I was the first to arrive in the scene, so I'm tasked with keeping the scene clean.
He clears his throat and I realize he was gesturing to me as he lifted the yellow tape. I decided to make my exit through the opening the officer had made. I look around and see that it looks like a typical robbery. Sad how lower life forms think that stealing is a way to sustain yourself. Little do they know that leads them to a dark path that they may not be able to return from. That is a story for another time. As I examined closer, it isn't a typical robbery. They didn't take anything.
Well, of course they didn't take anything. They weren't looking to get their paws on such a small catch. No, they wanted it to look like a messy robbery. No, this cat burglar had other intentions.
I recognized the soft voice as you started making your assessment. No matter how many realms that I've traveled through, hearing her speak is always warm and comforting. I turn my head and see a bear in a detective outfit, and a little cat peeking out from the top. As the cat leaps out from her jacket, I watch as it patrols the scene. I take this moment to speak with the detective. Hello there, detective.
Detective Seni Ursa of the Nyantianth Precinct. Pleased to meet you.
So it seems that this Seni Ursa is a world-class detective. An interesting turn of events that I'll have to investigate myself. For now, however, I decide to observe how she handles the crime scene. Several officers are now on the scene, making sure that it is closed off to the public and rerouting all away from the area.
So, Meow-scapades, you must have an idea why they would make this look like a messy robbery while taking Yanting. What were they really after?
I watch as the officers scratch their heads. The cat, who I assume is this universe's Belle, salutes Seni before leaping on her shoulder and whispering in her ear. Seni's eyes widen as if she is having a moment of genius. Meanwhile, the officers have given up on answering Seni's question.
Well, officers, if you were to look harder at the crime scene, you'd know that this shop is owned by the same jeweler that owns the Cat's Eye gem. One of their smaller ones, but one of theirs nonetheless. This wasn't a burglary. This was a message.
Belle gives her a small piece of paper she found inside the shop.
And what was that message? Well, they were nice enough to write it down, so allow me to read it for everyone.
She unfolded the paper and began reading in the voice of the evil cat burglar.
Listen up, jeweler. You will give me the cat's eye right meow. I'm done playing games. This was just the beginning. For each day that I don't have the cat's eye, one more store will be destroyed. Every nyan will pay for your resistance if I don't have it by next week. You woke up the tiger, and now you're gonna get the claws. You're very angry, Diamond Tiger.
A very aggressive cat burglar indeed. I decided to use cosmic magic to take on the guise of the foreign agent, Jerbear, from the land far away. Detective Saniersa, might I lend my own expertise to your investigation? I think that I could prove to be a valuable asset. I'm Agent Jerbear from a land far away. The detective gives me a smile that has rejection behind it.
Thank you, Agent Jerbear, but this city is a much different beast than the country. City cats do not sleep and have to claw their way to the top. I don't see how a slow and, pardon my bluntness, dim-witted bear could be of any assistance. So while it was very kind of you to offer your paw, I will have to politely decline.
I raise a brow and realize this wasn't going to be an easy task. However, much like she had a case that needed to be solved in a short amount of time, so did I. I needed to find out what was the shatter that changed the course of fate in this realm. A shatter is an event that has an unexpected outcome which causes it to be shaped differently than other universes. Sometimes these shatters are so great they create further cracks that can create another shatter. That shatter was my mystery case. What had caused a soft-spoken and gentle soul like a Saniersa to become a hardened and discerning detective? What event caused such an impact that, instead of traveling the world to find new friends, this Saniersa dedicated herself to a mission of justice? I understand, Detective Saniersa. I do have one question before you dismiss me completely. Which family was it that taught you to follow your instincts? Was it the clan of the Meow? Or the family Ursa? I watched as her ears twitched at my interrogation.
Excuse me?
Suddenly I could feel the air grow heavier. Almost as if it was a warning sign, the rest of the officers quickly went back into their cars and left the scene. Despite taking the hint, I pressed on. My apologies. Allow me to speak clearly and more deliberately. What answers are you hoping to find in bringing every criminal to justice? What great big wrong are you looking to right? Most importantly, what happened to your family? I can sense Saniersa's aura grow a little darker. I was inquisitive, not stupid. I took a deep breath and spoke almost in a whisper. I may be a slow and, in your words, dim-witted bear from the land far away, but that does not mean I do not have intuition. A detective has enemies they have to keep a watchful eye for. A successful detective has even more, but knows when not to make a new one. Perhaps we should discuss things over tea at some local cafe. Cities do have those, yes. As if the act of lowering my guard proved to her that I was trying to be an ally, Saniersa's dark aura dissipated, and she was back to her kinder demeanor.
Oh yes, and I know just the spot. Kitty Kitty Bang Bang. It's on the corner of Meowth Avenue and Main Streets.
And so, we were seated at Kitty Kitty Bang Bang. She must have been a regular as the maid sat us at a very private table in the back. From here, Sani sat. She could see all the entrances and easily exit from the back if necessary. The perfect seat for a world-class detective. I can tell by her posture, however. She didn't need to worry about this. As I took a sip from my tea, she effortlessly proved this by divulging her deductions. Deductions, had I not been a being of my caliber, may have almost caught me off guard.
So, Agent Jerbear, you're not from faraway land. You're not from around here, that's for sure. But I don't think you're from anywhere in this whole world, are you?
I put down my cup with a smile. I shouldn't be surprised. One thing that makes her a great detective that all sunny Ursas possess are a sharp wit and brilliant intelligence. So naturally, she was investigating my person the moment I stepped into her crime scene. Hold on, detective. You certainly do all the other sunny Ursas proud with your impeccable deduction. Do tell, though. How exactly is it that you came to that conclusion? I waited in bated breath as she went through her analysis.
Well, as a world-class detective, I make it my business to know about every officer of justice I can. Your name, Jerbear, is not one that's ever come up until the case of the Diamond Tiger. Then there's a matter of suddenly appearing at my crime scene, almost as if you were waiting for me without knowing who I was. And finally, you knew things about my past that I haven't told anyone. So either you can read minds, or you've seen into the life of a different me.
I was astonished at how flawless her logic was, and how she came to that conclusion. If we weren't meeting in secret, I would have given her a round of applause. I smiled, listening to her infectious laugh, as she could tell from my facial expression I was nothing short of impressed. However, the smile suddenly became a frown as she looked at me with her big, bare eyes.
Tell me, do different me's live a nice, quiet life with their cats? Do they travel the world making friends instead of enemies? Do they...
I watched as Belle pulled out a tissue for her to dry her tears with. I grabbed her paw and squeezed it a little. If I answered this question, would it change anything for you? No, I suspect not, and that isn't why I came here. Something happened to your family. I need you to tell me. She was brave, just like every other sunny Ursa. Perhaps even more so. She paused, and then told me her story.
Shortly after my birth, the family Ursa was murdered. I was taken in by the clan of Meow, and they taught me how to use my intuitions to solve things, which I eventually used to bring some of the worst, most dangerous criminals to justice. They had me promise one thing, though. And it was to never, ever seek revenge.
I looked down as I began to realize why she left the clan of Meow. Deep down, you could never keep that promise, could you? I think I found the shadow I was looking for. Detective sunny Ursa, as I said before, telling you about other sunny Ursa won't help you, nor will it give you the answers you seek. I will help you, though. I usually only observe until I need to do more. I only ask that you do one thing for me at this time. As we were getting ready to make our leave, I heard not her tough roar of a voice. Rather, I heard a more familiar tone.
And what would that be?
Solve the case of the Diamond Tiger.
That's it?
That's it. I could not tell her more than that, risk interfering too much. I observe until I need to do more. I only do as much as I need to. However, right now that required that sunny Ursa not only solve the case, but also apprehend the Diamond Tiger. I shall meet you again before the next week, or when you've solved the case, whichever comes first. And so we parted ways into the destined time that our paths would cross again. Time that came much sooner than even I had expected. It seems that Detective sunny Ursa, much like other sunny Ursas, has an unbreakable drive and ambition that, once set on a path, cannot be stopped. This time we met in an alley, across from a jewelry store, the Cat's Meow. It's only been a day, so would it be safe to assume you solved the case? Sunny Ursa let out a laugh, as she was rather proud of herself.
Yes, and they've set a nice little trap to catch the cat in the act. We had the jeweler put the cat's eye in this particular store, knowing that this is all the Diamond Tiger is after. Except he doesn't expect it to be here, since it's only the second store in his list.
How did you figure out this would only be a second store?
He said in the letter, "You woke up the tiger, and now you're going to get the claws." Cat's claws are retractable, so when they are ready to strike, it shoots out from the base of their paw. If you think of the city like a paw, the small store was at the city limits, or the base. Also, sometimes cats meow when they wake up. Just like the name of this jewelry store.
So now I suppose we wait then? Have you figured out the identity of the Diamond Tiger?
Not quite yet, but I have my suspicions they might have connections to the clan of Meow as well as the criminal group Cat Scratch Fever.
I notice the glint in her eye as her aura begins to shine bright. Just remember what I said. I will help you once you've solved the case. However, I add one more caveat. Listen to your kitty family. Do not seek revenge.
A tough bargain, but I will accept for now.
And so we waited for the Diamond Tiger, who arrived just as expected. The Diamond Tiger smashed through the jewelry store and was stunned to see the cat's eye in the middle of the store on display. The Diamond Tiger examined it cautiously, not believing it was the real cat's eye. After examining it for some time, the Diamond Tiger looked around to see what he would be up against. Seeing no one visible, he picked it up and laughed maniacally.
If this was a trap, it was a poorly constructed one. I have what I want, and you will come out empty-handed.
Just then, the security system kicked in, and the store was in complete lockdown as metal panels surrounded the store. The Diamond Tiger was too fast, however, and slipped through the vent. Once on the rooftop, the Diamond Tiger tried to use a grappling hook to escape to the next rooftop. Unexpectedly, the threads of rope unraveled, leaving the Diamond Tiger to plummet to the ground and left in a daze. If examined closely, it would appear that small wisps of gold pulled the rope apart. A very strange phenomenon indeed. Or what I like to call kintsugi. Well, detective, it appears you've got your villain. Are you ready for the big reveal? As the sirens could be heard, Sunny Ursa prepared to unmask the Diamond Tiger. With the other officers arriving and watching in suspense, Sunny Ursa grabbed the mask and yanked it off the Diamond Tiger.
Officers, I present to you the identity of the Diamond Tiger, the nefarious Claude Nyane of the Cat Scratch Fever gang.
And I would have gotten away with it if it weren't for...
Just then, Belle pops her head and has a diamond in her paws. The real cat's eye.
You would have run away with a fake. Surely you didn't actually think I was dumb enough to put the real cat's eye in danger from their paws, did you? Now, the only thing left is to get the motive. What was your reason for stealing the cat's eye, and why in such a destructive manner? Why not have the Cat Scratch Fever gang bully the jeweler for it?
And as I had promised, if she solved the case, I would give her the answer she had been hunting for. It's because this one was personal. You were given the blessing of the clan of Meow, something Claude had been working so hard to get. He even killed the Ursa family to prove his strength. Isn't that right? Claude, still in a rage, doesn't even notice that there is no way a simple detective could have known that. No, he's still focused on the fact that he once again was thwarted by his greatest enemy, Sunny Ursa.
Every time, what makes you so special? You're not even a cat. You're a stupid bear with a stupid face. I was to be the heir of the clan of Meow's secrets, not you. No matter how hard you try to be a cat, you aren't a cat. Have you even tried being more like a bear and not a cat? I hate you.
Sunny Ursa's ears started twitching again. I grew worried she would kill Claude out of anger. However, something very different happened. She stretched out her paw and pointed to Claude. Belle dashed down, scratched Claude's face, and then returned to her place in Sunny Ursa's jacket.
What makes me so special? Nothing. I'm just a bear that was raised by cats. You, though? You're a selfish and greedy boy that only thinks about himself. You want to know what the clan of Meow didn't give you any secrets? It's because you aren't worthy of them. Look inside yourself. You know that you're consumed by vengeance. Every time you've been wronged, instead of learning from it, you seek to hurt others. That's why you patched this plan, so you could hurt me for taking the family you didn't care for.
Shut up. You don't know anything.
Revenge will only lead you to an empty bowl. There is only one truth.
I watched as Sunny Ursa stands victorious while the Diamond Tiger is taken away. Once the vehicle sends him to jail, she addresses me.
How did you know that the Diamond Tiger was the one who killed the Ursa family?
It's because in another universe, another Sunny Ursa teaches him the secrets of the clan of Meow. She teaches him to let go of his vengeance and accept that one truth. In that universe, he confesses the murders that he ultimately did in a fit of rage. That Sunny Ursa forgives him after he dedicates himself to reconciling for his sins. So I had a hunch that this Diamond Tiger was one that did not have his heart touched by the great Sunny Ursa.
How did you know that I wouldn't have killed him? I mean, this is the killer I'd been looking for all my life. The one I sought vengeance over.
Another hunch. But I had a feeling that you weren't actually looking for revenge. No. You were looking for closure. And in a way, your own justice. Just as there is only one truth, there is only one justice. Revenge is not justice. It is a vicious cycle that only brings violence. Sunny Ursa walks over to the unraveled rope and picks it up to examine it.
A faultier rope? How peculiar. That if this rope hadn't unraveled, the Diamond Tiger might have escaped right through our paws.
As I said, I only observe until I need to do more. I simply repair cracks with gold. It's called Kenetsugi. This is where I take my leave, great Detective Sunny Ursa. Is there anything you wish to tell the other Sunny Ursa that I might meet? I watched as Sunny Ursa took a good while to contemplate my question.
Yes. To remember that there is always only one truth, and to always use their sharp wit to seek it out, even if it means doing things the hard way. Follow your heart and always listen to your instinct. Always remember that your wisdom will get you far, but your kindness will get you further. Do not let dark thoughts cloud your judgment, and always seek justice.
A nice sentiment, Detective. May all Sunny Ursa hold that mantra in their heart. And thus ends our tale for the night. Detective Ursa and the Great Meow-scapade.